Welcome to the Capture 2020 tutorial series. In this episode, we're going to take a look at snapshots, renders, and presentations. Snapshots live in the Snapshots tab and are recordings of the current DMX and media state of your project. Use the play stop button next to the snapshots to start playback, to jump between snapshots, and to end playback. Snapshots are recorded using the record button. This gives you a choice between a still snapshot or a movie snapshot. It's also possible to recall a snapshot, or rather the DMX of a snapshot. This allows you to continue working on a look and possibly update or replace it. If you wish to render an image from a live view in Capture, use the Save Image function in the view. Select Save Image. Type in a name of the image that will be rendered. I shall call it Render. Choose the file format you wish to use. The default is JPEG. Note that EXR is the proper file format to use for HDR renders. I'm going to proceed with JPEG in this case though. Press the Save button and select the resolution of the render and press Save. I can now find the rendered file on the desktop where I saved it, which is a render of the project file. We can also render movie snapshots by right-clicking on a movie snapshot and selecting Render Movie. In this case, we are typing in the name of the resulting MP4 file. I shall call it Movie Render. And now the option also includes a bitrate. This is the compression level of the MP4 produced. Now I'm going to deliberately render a low quality movie so that it is faster. You can see that a progress indication appears next to the render button that shows, well, the amount of percent complete of the render. You can interrupt the render at any point using the cancel button, which I'm going to do now. When you do this, the resulting MP4 file is cut short when you hit cancel. This does allow us to watch the first few seconds of the render. Finally, as an option to renders, there is also a concept in Capture called presentations. Presentations are like a mini version of the Capture software bundled together with your project file. To export a presentation, go to the File menu and select Export Presentation. Give a file name for the resulting presentation package. I will simply call it Presentation and save it to the desktop. The presentation file exported is actually a zip file, which means that it is ready for email or sharing with other people. In order to view the presentation file, extract the contents of the zip file and double-click on the corresponding presentation. On Windows, this will be the one that is called presentation and ends with .exe. If you're on Mac, it will be the other file that is unusable on Windows. So regardless of whether you're using the Mac or Windows version of Capture, you can export a presentation that will run on both platforms. Let's open the presentation. Let's accept the firewall question that appears. Now you can see that we're getting a live view. In fact, what we're getting is the alpha view from our design. And at the bottom are thumbnail images that allows us to replay the snapshots of the project file. And the reason we got the Windows firewall question on startup is that it is also possible to put the presentation in a mode where it accepts external incoming DMX, which is useful for pre-programming purposes. Thanks for watching and see you soon again.